into the pistol round here, as we actually did miss one of the frags. Yannick going down towards the A bomb site, but I am Sprawl, joined by Laz. How's it going, buddy?
Good, man. How are you?
Fantastic. And yeah, we got a round of 16 Pro Series Open Qualifier European match. Kaz Esports, they got ZNF on their lineup, if you guys recognize that name, but we'll get right into the action here. They found a pick early towards A, and they end up executing there. You saw Smuya alone towards quad. Now we will have Jess towards truck. We got ZNF coming up from truck as well. Rom finding a single frag as he comes up from highway. So this is a situation where it could work out, but in theory, if VWS just plays this soundly and that they just play trades and don't give too many 1v1s, well, we will see Fender go down. But again, a trade comes out. ZNF will fall. I'm playing a player in Squeaky. This is so rough for the CT side. And honestly, that was a great look on the post plant for VWS. I didn't even realize that was an ace from Eminic. I probably should have recognized that. But anyhow, moving forward, first round going to go to the T side.
Yeah, it was a nice job. They were able to just play the quad and hold their positions really well and just play good crossfires. Really well done from VWS.
Indeed, indeed. So this is the map choice of VWS. We got Inferno for Kaz, and Train is our third map if required. So imagine, again, VFS. I don't know why I wanted to say it. Vancouver Film School. That's what I'm going for. VWS. Gaming. Again, they are going to purchase some rifles here. We can see a couple SMGs, but very slow start to the round.
Yeah, the CTs are just trying to find some information, see where the Ts are actually going to be going. And if you look on the minimap right now, you can actually see that they're stacking highway. And the CTs are going to get ready to push here.
This is looking like a cool setup, honestly. And we will see two frags going the way. Make it three of towards the CT side. So, wow. Right back at him. Fender and Derkayak. Gonna be all alone, considering they only have SMGs. They will find another pick. Yannick getting a little aggressive towards sandbags. But again, Rom being so close to the mid warehouse with his AK. This is honestly a nice setup for the CT side if the Ts decide to push into it. But they do have plenty of time to work elsewhere. I don't know if I agree with this boost, as they will head up and over Fender. He will fall to Rom, and now Derkayak is in a lonely spot.
It's a really good job from the CTs. Like, they had a really good setup. They just played like the three or four on the catwalk and then one in Z with a pot flash and then just pushed the Ts right now.
We'll see the bomb go down. So in theory, could make this work. Trying to find the spray on a Yannick though, and the MAC-10 just not gonna get it done. Versus an armored opponent, that's kind of what you're gonna see, unfortunately. And good news for CT side, they win the round and they recover two AKs off of it. That's pretty fantastic.
Very, very expensive round for BWS right now. So now they're gonna have to do pretty much a full save. Unless you're gonna go for a tech armor aggression, but they did get bombed down, so it does actually look like they're gonna go for a bit of a pistol armor buy here, so some mollies as well too.
Yeah, quite a bit of utility. I'm actually very interested to see where Fender goes with that Molotov, as seeing some tricky things from these European squads. See what we can get going, as we'll be headed towards B main. We will peek from Sunroom here. Bomb hasn't been shown just yet. They will split towards the vents very early, and finding a pick towards highway, not so bad, but ZNF and Jesp coming up with decent frags there, and it will be a 3-on-4. This is kind of falling apart a little bit for the T side, as they still have a bit of utility, but unfortunately, it looks like it is all for naught. Fender left in a 1v4, and with a P250 in armor, yeah, it's probably not going to work out. And I'm not going to lie, I should have spotted where Fender utilized that Molotov, but I didn't. I don't know if you had eyes on that.
Yeah, I did. It was really unfortunate. Like, it looks like they just got clustered by the smoke on B main, and then I'm not too sure who it was. I think it was Jesp that was able to grab one or two there right away, so just stopping the T rush and aggression, so really well done from Kaz.
Kaz Esports. Yeah, Kaz.
Okay.
I believe it's a UK lineup. If not, it at least used to be. I'm not too familiar with the players other than ZNF, and I do know ZNF, at least my understanding. I think he's originally from North America. Anyhow, just moving overseas. Nonetheless, see if he can get going on this roster, as we'll be up to a 2-1 lead. Actual save coming out for VWS, and looks like they're going for some sort of boost play here, as actually initial engagement here. Smuya goes down as he tries to push into a middle smoke. A little aggressive, but ZNF taking a little bit of damage towards Highway, takes a duel though and wins it. Jesp, similar situation. Looks like CTs will be able to find a foothold and bring this round right back, but Jesp down to 28, but actually taking both of those frags very nicely. So three frags on the round for him and 3-1 for Kaz.
Very nice hold from Kaz. Just able to hold off the T's, just trying to get some information of picks. Really interesting from VWS too, because they were trying to just dry run everything. It looked like they were just trying to get, you know, picks and just see if they can get some P250 kills, but not a bad try, but full gun round, so we'll see what happens here.
AK's on the field. We see an op on Smuya, and he will head towards B. So the setup looks like they'll play him alone for the moment. I don't know if they'll have any Vents aggression just yet. Jesp slowly moving up underneath the boost spot. And Fender has made his way into Sunroom. I think Smuya had potentially spotted him, but Jesp playing underneath the boost in middle. He's got Rom playing a crossfire with him towards Sandbags, and CT is just playing a very mid-heavy setup at the moment, and to be fair, that's not a bad read on the situation, as we should see BWS might lurk on out. Actually, maybe not. Considering Shaq has the bomb in his back, I don't think he's going to go out alone. I think he's just providing a little bit of presence here as they work towards A.
Yeah, he's just trying to make a bit of a noise and distraction right now. But what I really like right now is that Kaz actually got, three, right up mid and getting control right away. So BWS has been trying to get mid control the whole time, these last couple rounds, so they just took aggression and just completely got that map control. So that's really good job from Kaz. And now they just know the information. They either know they're just going to commit A, or most likely A or maybe B, but I think they're leaning towards A.
Yeah, looking at the moment towards A, and having Jesp underneath the boost as well, you can get kind of some audio feedback from A main, see if you can hear them at all, as this is actually an interesting setup from Kaz, as they've more or less forfeited the bomb site. They just want to know for certain if it's going to be this bomb site, but looks like they have gathered in that intel as Yannick finds a frag and he will stay alive towards truck. There is still a lurk towards middle. Defender finds an excellent one, but ZNF, one more as they come in on the retake here. It's going to be one player towards quad, one on the safe spot. Fender very low as he's inside of A main, and Derkayak will have to run on out here as he's mollied out of quad. It will be a 2-on-3. CT's running out of time a little bit here. Derkayak taking a duel, doing a little bit of damage there to Jesp as they're going to try and go up and over, and Shaq will fall in the end. So three left up for Kaz, good for their economy, and honestly just so calm and concise in the retake. They just, even when they knew, like you had stated, they had presence in middle, it was still a bit of a guessing game whether or not it would be towards B or A, but having that player underneath boost, it kind of gathers that extra bit of intel, and they play that really well.
Yeah, it was really well done job from Yanni. I'm just going to call him Yanni on the CT side. Got a nice 3K getting in that site with the retake. Props to VWS, though. They did have really good angles, and they were playing properly, but it was just unfortunate that none of them were actually getting the frags. So it was just a little bit of gunpowder wasn't working there, so hopefully
at the end of the day, need to get those frags, right? Oh, speaking of frags, Shaq actually just runs into B and finds one. Rom trades off as he falls from Vents, but VWS able to trade off of that, and now they do have control of B, but they don't necessarily have the bomb there. That being said, ZNF, see if he can find a timing through this middle smoke. It looks like it's not going to dissipate in time for him to really catch anybody off. Actually, he just barely spotted the barrel of 1T. So it will be another retake scenario. Oh yeah, finding Fender, as that was a situation where I don't know if the T really needs to be there, but at the same time, you want to make sure that the CTs aren't gathering that real estate, and there's no utility on the T side to smoke off or Molotov off. But the bomb does go down. Playing very passive at the moment. Here's ZNF inside of the Vents, and the rest of the squad even. They're just waiting for some sort of pick. Yannick's gonna Molotov right on top of the safe spot on the bomb site. ZNF eventually looking to find a timing, but he will be taken down from a player underneath Heaven, and immediately VWS will take all of the frags as they try and retake on that CT side.
Very good job from BWS. They just all had good positioning, and they all just played the right angles to trade off with each other. You had someone B main, you had someone under Heaven, you had someone in the backside as well. Just gaining all that information was a really well done job.
Yeah, this is honestly excellent so far. I love to see this kind of play. Looking really really good on both sides, but it will be Kaz in the lead. Shaq looking for a middle peek or a middle pick potentially, and well, Smuya's gonna find him as he did line up that angle. So early frag going the way of the CT side, and well, if you're VWS, you definitely don't want to drop this round. Yeah, you survived with three in the last, but your economy's not necessarily comfortable as they will push a player into B main. Maybe you're trying to find another B side play.
I really like where Kellen is right now. He's in checker, and I don't know if the CTs actually know that he's gotten control. Maybe they do now, but it's a really good spot for him because he's able to maybe get a pick in sight now, but Rom looks like he's about to find him here, though.
Yeah, he's trying to play the timing on the smoke because he doesn't want it. He's super vulnerable taking that fight as his back's turned to B main, and he doesn't necessarily win it in time, but he does fall off and eventually takes the frag in the end, as we'll see the ops come out to play. Kayak. Ooh, thought that was just going to be a swift headshot, but it's a little off its mark, and eventually he goes down to the USPS in a flawless round to come back into it from Kaz, and VWS, not quite the look they were looking for.
No, it's a really good job from, is it Smoothia? Smooth? I'm going to call him Smooth.
Smooya? There you go.
Smooya? Yeah. All right. Good job from Smooya. You know, being the operator inside a site like that, you know, getting two is crucial, but anything more is obviously just a bonus. So good job from him. He got a big 3K holding down that site with ROM as well. So the CTs are playing really good. They have good setups and just getting really good crossfires.
So we'll see what can transpire on the eco here for the T side. Smooya is going to drop an interesting incendiary. Prevents it. Any quick highway aggression, really, unless you want to peek super, super wide, but that's not going to be the case. As you see, Kalinka has pushed up to that highway box. They're looking for an A setup of sorts, but they have no smokes at all. Honestly, the only real investment is this Deagle invest, as Kalinka looking to hop around the corner. Smooya has lined up the angle, and Smooya, if you're looking at his crosshair placement, it is actually so sporadic. Eventually finds Linka, not going to find the follow-up shot. He was essentially planning for a player to jump around the corner, so he's kind of pre-setting up his crosshair play. I don't know, it looked very bizarre, but very cool at the same time, as we're going to see another flawless round for the CTs.
You know, I'm not too sure why VWS or VWS didn't buy any utility at all. Like, I think it would have been beneficial for them to, you know, purchase at least a smoke and a molly, cover off that truck, molly out to someone in quad, and get a little bit of control of the site. Taking the dry run like that is a bit problematic, but it's a good effort anyways. It was a save round, so hopefully they can make some work here with this gun round, because they are down four rounds.
I can see with no bomb plant and such, they actually come into the round with not a lot. They've already deployed two of their smokes just to attempt to get out middle, but nice pre-fire from the CTs. Klinka spots one towards the sandbags, but they just can't take middle. Eventually, Derkai comes over the boost, and we will have Fender with him, but playing the side of the smoke, that's actually an angle that I don't think that smoke actually landed sound, excuse me, as they had a player up on the spindle, and he was able to spot the leftmost side of it, and I think they were able to abuse that, so Kaz just coming out on top again.
I really, really like that setup that Kaz did. They played an aggressive mid, and they also got their opera to push the door and just get a bunch of information. So then they were able just to capitalize, and they knew right away they're doing a full mid commit, like the VWS. So really well done job from Kaz. Just, again, getting map control information. That's what you need to do on CT side.
Yeah, so we will see Rom potentially getting aggressive here. This is an anti-eco, but he wants to line up some players as he finds three. Klinka finding the first frag of the match for himself, as he's not looking too great at the moment. 1-3 Annie. We'll see if he can pick it up. And 8-2. The economy on that CT side, honestly, is it's incredible. That's all you can really say about it. Over 10k on multiple players.
Yeah, Kaz is just laughing right now. They have so much money in the bank right now. You have one person with 12, 11, and then everybody else over with over 5. So these guys can just purchase as much as they want and not have to really worry as much right now, too. And they're up with so many rounds right now, they can just try to do different things to throw VWS off guard. Like, they can play more aggressive, they can do more stacks. The ball's in the court right now.
So we will see Rom aggressively heading into vents. Jess playing op angle from checkered here. And interesting setup in that now they've kind of not necessarily given up middle, but Smooya all alone. So a bit of a different look, as I think he just barely spotted ahead peeking over the boost, and he will take the shot. Hits him. See if he can actually... I don't think he's going to be able to burn him to death. That would be pretty crazy, though. Anyhow, he falls off of the boost. And again, if you're afraid of the different setups, and if you're VWS, of course you would be at this point. You're getting so many different looks. And now Smuya showing up with that AWP. I don't know what VWS is going to try here.
I think their best success so far is they've been able to get B control, if I'm not mistaken, one of the rounds that they actually won. And they had really good placement as well with like all their players. So I think if they can utilize getting the site control, especially with all the mollies that they have right now, like not molly in the site and then smoke off everything, they could be able to take it. But they've been really focusing on that mid control.
Yeah, which I guess you can't blame them for, but if it's not working, well, see if they can get this rolling as they've got 35 seconds. Jesp gets absolutely latered. It's out of the back of the bomb site, but Rom comes up with two. Smuya with one, and they'll leave the CTs at a advantageous position. That being said, the bomb is going down. Fender finding another. It will be a 2-on-2, and I think this B bomb site is looking much better for the T side. As they've got a player set up inside of the bomb site, safe. Fender, ooh, he's going for the tricky plays. He's going all the way around. And we'll see how far. Yeah, I don't think he's going to go all the way to CT. We'll drop from vents. But that in itself could be a bit of a tricky play, as unless they heard him. No, he gets a freebie for himself. It's now only Z and F, and he will put a ton of damage into the T and eventually take the fight. Wins it through the box. Eminik was kind of in a position where he got tagged. He didn't initially want to take the fight on that term, and then he just gets headshot, and well, that's the round.
It was definitely a good effort. I'm not sure if Fender was thinking of trying to flank like all the way from mid to Z, but then he was probably just thinking, oh, I'll just go vent. But it was a really good job anyways. He was still able to pick off one and then made it down to a one-on-one. But close round. Like I mean, the B bomb site's been their biggest success so far, so hopefully they can start capitalizing on taking B rather than mid control, so...
Yeah, no, I'd have to agree, and yeah, like, that the round that you were highlighting, the second round that they were able to take, they just actually had players sprinting into B, and I think they were able to catch the CTs off guard, which I don't think they can necessarily just do that straight up again, but definitely that kind of aggression could be what'll pan out for them. That being said, this A take, oof, unfortunately now not trading favorably for the T side. It's only Klinka left as ZNF. It's fully widescreen, and the way he just crouched behind truck was so ninja-like. As Klinka was about to take his head off and loses his target, and now stuck in a 1v3 towards Fork. Doesn't have position to get the bomb down. Not even a position to even really bait a shot out, as we'll take one fight, and Rom dropping. Not just will hit him as he peeks out wide to the left, and that'll be the round 10-2, double digits for Kazan. Again, I was not expecting this kind of lopsided of a scoreline. That being said, I don't think VWS is completely out of this, but not a lot to work in for him.
No, Kash is one of those maps that I personally find that is really, really 50-50. It's become one of, like, the dust two, where it can be CT or T-sided. And it all depends on, it obviously just depends on your team, but I could definitely see VWS coming back as a CT side, because they might be stronger as a defense rather than their offense, so. Be favorable for them to win this, or, you know, come back with a half at, like, 10-5, but we'll see what happens. This is a gun round, so.
Again, they'll be in another situation where they're kind of lacking some utility, though, as we'll see two smokes, and that's pretty much it. I think they did come into the round with a little bit more. I've missed a little bit being tossed out, but nonetheless, it's going to be Rom with the first frag, as that was from Sandbags. And this mid presence, again, from Kaz, is just not able to make anything work, and the single player boost over and try and take control doesn't, again, seem to be working, as we will see, actually, ooh, this could get pretty good here for Kaz as they boost Smuya up, and we'll see how patient he is with this. The players that in my eyes play it the best are the ones that, again, don't just fly over mid. They actually wait for a timing. And although Smuya's not going to see very much here, you might eventually get the peek towards a squeaky player, and indeed he does. They peek as soon as there's some sort of engagement that would pull attention to another target, then they boost over. And it's just a kind of a stark difference between a team that coordinates those kinds of plays and one that doesn't.
Right, you are, Sprawl. It's a really good play. Like you mentioned, you usually see, like, I'm going to pull the NA card out, but you usually see a lot of lower tier players. They will just kind of boost over and run up mid right away. Whereas the higher tier players, such as you're seeing now, they're waiting for that engagement, and then he's going to push after that. Because, like, they're so distracted, and then he's going to be able to, like, flank them and get information and get a frag. So it's really, really good job on the boost. And just, again, getting control. Like, he knew no one was aiming. He's like, hey, he's going to be squeaky. And then he utilized on it and capitalized. So it was a good job.
11-2, two rounds left here in the first half, and Kaz not showing any signs of slowing down. As we'll see again, a single player boost here. They will win that duel. SB though firing back as he finds a pick towards B main, so they immediately give up the advantage. To be fair though, 4-on-4, they can definitely make this work. If they have a player actually lurking out into the bomb site, that's because Smooya actually pushed through Squeaky and found a frag that way, but they've given up an op, so this 3-on-3 has actually got a little awkward for Kaz.
Yeah, it was not a bad job. It was just unfortunate that no one else was on the A bomb site. Like, it was just Smooya just played by himself, pushed the door a bit late, and then lost the site. So now VWS is going to be able to take over the site, get the bomb down, and it's down to a 3-on-1.
Now only Yannick, and tell me it's not so. He's going to find one. As Klinka was actually kind of peeking the edge of a smoke. Both players remaining. Yeah, they have obs, but they are so low. So either of them whiff a shot. That should be the ticket here. And Yannick. Okay.
Nice.
Yannick, or I believe it was Klinka, rather, that missed a shot from Quad, but we'll have his teammate hit the shot. So moving into the final round. Again, VWS optimal scoreline is 4, but still leaves quite a bit to be sought after.
It would have been good for Yanni to land that smoke, obviously, more connected more on the highway. Would have just completely shut off the other player in highway with that op, which was Shaq. And it just made it a 1-on-1 against Callan. So it's unfortunate that it missed, but nonetheless, good job from DWS to capitalize on that passive A setup. So.
Oh man, Smooya is just hitting bodies right now. A little headshot on that one. But first, lines up from highway box towards mid main. They give him the peek, takes it, and then from highway box, he spotted before he peeked the head of the player, and then basically just pre-aimed, peeks wide, takes the head off, and well, if you're VWS, you can't afford to be giving up those kinds of picks, and now they're left on a 3-on-5 with, well, they've got a little bit of map control, but nothing that's really working for them.
Yeah, it seems like VWS has just been clustered more in the middle. Like, they're just not able to, like, capitalize on anything. Like, they're almost scared to make a big play here. But it's a good job for Kaz, because, like I said, they're playing a bit unpredictable, they're playing different setups, and it's throwing them off guard. And you can really, really see it from VWS that they're just not able to really get a full read on the CT setup. So they've always just been sitting in the mid and not too sure and trying to get information, but...
Even just in the position, ZNF takes 2 from underneath the boost and then throws an incendiary down at mid main, and Eminek's like, how does he know? Like, he's like, in a 5v1, he's going to play that safe, that he mollies and falls back to sandbags and plays safe and then finds his triple kill in the end. That was, honestly, Kaz is playing so disciplined. I'm very impressed from their CT side, and if VWS can't really mimic or duplicate the discipline and just the play that we saw from Kaz. And Kaz, the difficult thing is generally, if you have a really sound defense, your offense is almost built upon your knowledge of the defense, because you know how to exploit your own plays generally. So this is definitely rough, and this is the map choice of VWS.
Yeah, it's a really good job from Kaz. Like, they like you mentioned, like they just played such a disciplined CT side. Like, they were able to play different setups, play aggressive, just get control and just throw the T's off guard. Like, they made a perfect CT side. Like, winning 12-3 on cash is a huge, huge deal. Like I said, like, this map can go any way, but I definitely think if you're good on a CT side, like, you're most likely going to be pretty efficient as well on T side, so... Hopefully we can see some rounds come in from VWS and win that pistol to kind of bring back a few more.
Yeah, we'll see, as Inferno's going to be the next map, and that's Kaz Esports map choice. So the upside is VWS will have side selection. They'll get that CT side start, and maybe they can start rolling in that fashion. But yeah, it kind of leaves a bitter taste in your mouth when you get dominated on your own map. And even though you're moving to CT side Inferno is just... It's a map that if you're playing against a really, really, like, a team that picks it themselves, you're going to be in for a very, and again, the discipline that we've been seeing from Kaz, their T side on that map, I guess I should speak before we see the T side for them on cash, but I've just got to think that they're going to play the kind of slow, disciplined game on that T side that we kind of, to be fair, kind of hate to see in some regards on Inferno, but it works so well, and if on the CT side, you aren't really, really well coordinated in a way to fend it off, it can be a rough look as well.
think it's going to really depend on how well VWS plays this next half. It can really make a big determination of how well they're going to play on Inferno, in my eyes. I personally love Inferno. It's just one of my favorite maps in the game. So, I mean, CT side is crucial. Like, you need to have good coordination. I think Kaz is going to be able to pull off a really big half on their CT side on Inferno, because if you're looking at it right now, like, they're just playing so well-disciplined and able to capitalize on everything they can do.
For sure is. And we'll see. These guys readying up. Almost there. Moving into the second half here. If you guys are just joining us, again, this is map number one, best of three, in the round of 16 for our open qualifiers for the 2016 Pro Series at RGM. Just, again, just waiting for these guys. Clink is asking similar things. ZNF, taking the bathroom break, but looks like we are ready to rock here. So, excited to see right from the get-go what kind of utility, what kind of gear we see on the field. As gotta wait for that live on three, of course. But of course, like we were highlighting, VWS, no room for mistakes. Don't want to drop pistol. Really want to get those first three right, nice and early. Interesting setup here on the CT side is they go, well, for one, they're all on USPS and they all go armor.
Yeah, so this, they're doing just a normal setup, like a 2-1-2 on the CT side. And it does look like the T's actually are grouping up towards that B bomb site, but they are just kind of playing really passive and waiting to see if the CTs are going to start doing a big push or anything. So kind of like this, because it has been common that you see a lot of CTs like try to get like some kind of map control. Like we've seen like big B pushes or something to get information, but Kaz is able to just read them like a book there.
Kalinka will avoid the first flash, but unfortunately he's allowing players into the bomb site. He doesn't get a single player for his efforts. Eminent gets smoked off, and this is looking really, really bad at this point. Jespy has a smoke as well for the post plant. They will have a player towards middle, but Smuya is still in the boost spot. Ooh, this might actually go down, and he does. So this all of a sudden changes things drastically, as now they'll have vents to utilize as well. Well, and Derkaya coming up massive, and holy frags, Batman. We'll see two on Shaq, three on Derkaya, and VWS, you could hear it. I counted them out on that retake, and they totally brought it back.
That was a really good retake from VWS. They just played passive, they communicated, and then, I don't know how to say this guy's name, I'm just going to call him Derek?
Derkayak, I don't know.
Derkayak? Derkayak, yeah. Opening it up with three huge frags, just coming in, getting a pick in the quad, jumping down, getting the guy below heaven. Like, it's just crucial. Getting those picks in sight is massive, because then you can just get the guy lower CT to push in the sight right away, because they had other T players in the B main as well, so really well done.
And this is not necessarily, this is actually kind of an awkward buy here. They are not necessarily saving, but they're not necessarily forcing. They're keeping like $1,000, and well, it doesn't look like they're going to get anything out of the round here. Smuya, he actually bait plants. They actually found some frags. The 1v3, I guess I don't blame him to try and win the round there, but at the same time, bomb plant would have been pretty nice, as again, you could see they are in another safe scenario. And yeah, that's, I don't know if you can say very much about that buy. They left themselves around like $1,000. Generally, if you see a force buy, they're going to commit to it. Or if they're not going to, they're going to buy AKs in the third. That was kind of an interesting one.
Yeah, a bit of an interesting buy for sure. And just as you mentioned with the bomb plant too, like it's such a 50-50 thing to do, because you don't know if the CTs are closer. Like in his eyes, he was like, oh, there's probably someone right behind me. So if I fake right. plant, I can get a quick pick. And I mean, you know, it's just playing a bit of chicken. Like, what do you do? It was a good effort though. Almost got the bomb down. Able to get, I think, two people down that round, so. Yeah.
Too bad. They will keep the economy in check because of that. And you can see rifles on the field across the board. Of course, VWS wouldn't necessarily want that in this situation, and that they're against pistols, the SMGs that they lost in the last round. Would have been nice here. But of course, buying into the rifle game. We actually might see a boost here. Interesting decision on the anti-eco. You don't really expect that, though. That being said, he only finds one and gives up a rifle. I don't know. I don't know if I necessarily like it, but go for the aggressive play.
Yeah.
No, 3-on-4.
My bad. Definitely one of the things, yeah, like as you mentioned, like when you're going against eco rounds, like I really don't think it's smart for the team with the guns to be playing very aggressive, because you're just giving up the opportunity to lose your weapons and getting taken out. I mean, you had you had the boost and he was able to get two kills, which is good, but now you've just given the T's an M4. So now it's down to a 3-on-4, and if Yanny can pick up something here with that M4, like, it's just going to open up the bomb site for them and then make this worse for BWS.
They're going for the bait and switch as well. Yannick not necessarily committing to it right from the get-go, and he may have been able to make it work. He shows up right when Fender does. Now it's Rom now alone, and he won't be able to find anything more. Honestly, that two-person fake, though, they didn't even necessarily have to leave a main. And they were pulled off of the bomb site, but again, came down to timing. CTs were back in time at B.
Yeah, it's a really good job from BWS to be able to capitalize on these three rounds up to the pistol. So now this is a lot of pressure for them. This can be a motivational thing as well, too. Like, if they're able to win this gun round, this could throw Kaz off guard and get really flustered, depending on their team atmosphere and their team morale right now. But, I mean, they should be laughing. They have six rounds against BWS, so we'll see what happens on this gun round.
So we're going to see mid control here for the T side, and already a bit of a difference in the CT setups. They're actually working the old-fashioned shroud boost. We got a smoke down, Emanick boosting Shaq, not the run boost that we're used to seeing. But playing 3 and A, they'll give up middle, and Derkaik's going to be watching from a highway. They will actually boost a player in events, but Klinka goes down. And that's kind of what Kaz is hoping for. They take mid control and they're like, okay, let's hold on to it and see if anybody peeks us. And Fender peeks out from B main from Checkered rather, as they were aggressing from B main. Derkaik's gonna whiff his first shot as they're crossing into the bomb site. Now B bomb site control. Rom's still in middle. This is like a save scenario here, and indeed they will head back to A.
Yeah, it's a good thing for the CTs to do, especially with a 3-on-5, and it's a gun round. They might as well be saving these guns so that they can capitalize on the next round and be able to win it. There's no point of going for it, especially when there's five players up, and the bomb's been down for quite some time too. So you know that they have good crossfires, so it just makes it a lot harder. And they have tons of utility to save as well, so it's a good call by VWS.
Indeed, and yeah, 3 can drop the remaining 2 as well. Gives you a good chance moving into the next, as the downside is that Kaz gets to survive with 5 for free, so it's kind of like, that kind of sucks, but you get another chance at a gun round. So again, it's a bit of a catch 22 there, as again, 5 left up, Kaz getting the immediate luxury of being able to buy after losing a round, or pretty much. Smeo is going to be down fairly low, but otherwise with 3k on everyone else, we'll be sitting all right. And they will be able to get, again, they got that op still on that CT side. Klinko's a little low in equipment. He's got only FAMAS as he heads towards middle, and we'll see what kind of changes they implement moving into this round.
This is a really, really, really big round for BWS. Like, they have full guns now. You have one player with a FAMAS, but this is huge. Like, if they can win this round, this could really throw off the money for Kaz as well. And if they lose this round, then their money situation is going to be really goofed, and it could cost them the game here. So with 3 rounds to spare for Kaz to win this, a lot of pressure's on BWS.
Yeah, definitely. Considering Kaz is in a spot where they could even, again, force if they lose a round, whereas VWS is like, they're forcing, but it's not for the reasons that Kaz would be, as they've got no money really behind this. Fender will spot a player heading into the checkered smoke there. Rom taking a lot of damage as well. Zenef with one pick. Well, this is looking all right. That timing for Kaz, as they tried to work in towards checkered, didn't pan out. Maybe they can get something else done. They still have time, and Smuya has worked his way up highway here. He's on top of the box at the moment. Did not spot Derkaik, though, from quad. So again, looks like this will pan out quite well, but Kaz, if on their camp, you gotta be thinking, well, I guess in fairness, you could save these, but the economic damage would be fairly huge. And the setup actually towards A with only Derkaik there, maybe they can find a 2-on-1.
This is gonna be pretty big because ZNF's already got 10 HP and it's a 2-on-4 right now to go into the A bomb site.
Oh,
great,
wow.
Pick coming in though, yeah.
That was so sick. They like jump shoulder peek to try and bait out a shot and then fly out together. ZNF with 10 hit points finds the frag, and now this is a winnable situation. ZNF is low, but he's got an AWP. One bullet would find a frag. Will not be able to find Klinka, as Yannick should be able to take him down and does so. The two remaining players coming up from truck side, I don't know if they necessarily recognize this, as ZNF You haven't gathered that intel. He's checking back towards a main. He will go down on the wide peak, but traded off yet again. And that's the important part, as Eminek now in a 1v1. Yannick spots him out, and he will be able to take him down. What a round. And that's just morale crushing for VWS, as they just came back from a 2-on-4 with one player at 10 hit points.
You got to give it to ZNF, man. He
so like sick.
What you said. I mean, he just did the shoulder peek, did a little bit of a hop, and then just managed to capitalize and kill that guy right away. And the way that VWS was playing that is they just wanted one person anchoring the site, and then they had everybody else spread out, which they wanted to do a retake. But unfortunately, like, Kaz just were able to capitalize on the frags and just took them out one by one by one. So really good job from ZNF and the Kaz guys.
Beautiful play coming out as we see 14-6. Pistols on the CT side, not looking too hot. They will be saving for the next round, and well, not looking too good considering they're going to be fighting back to fight for overtime, and they're still on 6 rounds. So see if they can maybe get something going here, but they're down a player already and forced to play a 2-2 setup. Nothing too crazy. We talk about these rounds quite often. You need to create some chaos, and that's definitely something we're not seeing here in this round, as it will be a B-side execute. Klinka from heaven. See what he can find, as eventually he will peek out. Molotovs will actually botch. One of them, the one towards the back site, that allows a small window for that player with the CZ-75, but Derkarik, last one from middle, and looks like Kaz will survive with 5, moving on to map point.
Yeah, it was really unfortunate for Fender, because when you're having the CZ, like, it's so crucial for you to land, like, the first shot, like, to get that instant dink. When you miss those first couple shots, like, it's usually just, it's not going to go in your favor at all. So, and he got lucky as well, like you mentioned, like, there was a Molotov that actually missed and hit the edge of the window, and it didn't actually land on him. So he did have a good position. It was just really unfortunate that his aim battle just didn't go through.
So 15-6. Could be the last round here of our first map. Again, this is VWS Gaming's map choice, so not looking too good, as Smuya receiving a boost up middle for a player towards highway. Klink actually is peeking out, trying, I think he, Knifeout was trying to peek out in a way that he was gathering info. I think he may have been able to time that in a way that maybe Dekai could actually peek off of it. I thought that that's what they were trying to line up, but we'll see the pick go the way of Smuya nonetheless. And another 5-on-4 as VWS scramble to try and find a decent setup with the mount count.
Yeah, I'm not too sure if I agree with that peek from the CT, like, looking at boost like that. Like, you know that Smuya has an off, so you know he's probably going to be booster quick peeking mid. But yeah, unfortunately, Smuya just took him out, and now he's got a second one as well on Shaq. So I've got mid control fully now.
Looks like Kaz going to be able to close out here, as Smuya just finding the picks as they essentially, like you highlighted, kind of give it to him, as that's definitely a favorable spot, just a headshot or just your head peering over the boost, and they have like a full body peek. But nonetheless, taking into B, looks like we got Emek alone as he's a rotator coming from CT spawn. And have a quick duel here with Smuya. Smuya whiffing. Eminek will find him, but a 1v3 without a kit. The bomb goes down. Smokes down towards CT.
It's not looking favorable at all for him.
Right. Not liking his chances as he tries to take a random scope, no scope, quick scope, whatever you want to call it. He does find Jespy in the end, but it's going to be 16-6. Dominant map for Kaz.
Yeah, like, hats off to Kaz. Like, they honestly just played so well. Like, they were able to get the entries, get control of the map, and just made VWS just, like, sit around and not know what to do. Like, you could just see that on their T side, VWS was just sitting in mid, and they were trying to figure out, and they were probably communicating with each other, but they weren't able to capitalize on anything because Kaz would just mix it around and throw them off guard. So really good job from Kaz. And then that one round with the 2-on-4 was just a huge demoralizing thing for VWS as well.
Like, that was, losing something, that was like kind that, of a comeback killer right there. Like, yeah, that
exactly. Was, yeah. Like, when you lose big rounds like that, like, Counter-Strike's a motivational game. So, I mean, if something like that happens to your team, you know, usually everyone just gets pretty upset, and, you know, takes a lot to come back from that. But it's really unfortunate for VWS, but hopefully they can pull through here on Inferno. So
find out, as we are going to take a short break here, guys, but like Laz has stated, Inferno is our second map, so don't go too far. We'll be back in just a few.